This is a review of Drevo Blade Master TE Mechanical Keyboard. The switch that I have here is Get Around Red. Cutting the tape and opening the box. On the top, we have a bag of accessories. There is a Drevo branded wire keycap puller, which I think it looks pretty nice. And a brush that is wrapped in another layer of the plastic bag. This one is not branded though, but this is the first time that I see a keyboard include a brush with their package. Anyways, underneath the keyboard, there is a feedback card and a paper manual with a Drevo sticker inside. And that's everything inside the box. Unwrap the keyboard and I guess we have a Drevo branded dust cover. This is a pretty solid keyboard and I think they put a lot of work and thoughts into the design. I am going to start with the keycaps. The keycaps here are ABS and will attract a lot of fingerprints very easily. However, all the labels including the secondary labels are translucent. The backlight can shine through everything that are printed on the keycaps, and there are barely any lightning bleeds. As a Mac user, I do appreciate that they try and have these small labels for Mac keyboard terms. And I love the way they mark this keyboard theirs. They have the Drevo logo printed on the spacebar, and aligning it with the letters underneath, which I personally think it is very nicely designed. The keyboard is looking pretty solid, but it really shines when we turn on the RGB. It has the light bars on all sides of the keyboard that lights up your whole table. On the left-hand side, we have this wheel that works with the 6 function above the arrow keys, and let's quickly go through it. By hitting Fn plus insert, you will be able to choose the lightning style for the keyboard. It will cycle through 10 different styles from the number row as you spin the wheel. When you hit Fn plus delete, you can adjust the brightness of the keyboard. It has about 15 levels of brightness here including off, so I'm sure you can find the one that works best for your environment. Fn plus home lets you adjust the animation speed, and Fn plus end lets you select the sub lightning style or pick a color depending on the primary style that you set with Fn plus insert. So when you're in one of these 4 lightning modes, you can single click the knob to toggle on and off the switch lights, and double click to toggle the side lights. Other than the lightning controls, when you're in the page up mode, you can use the knob to control your media playback. You can spin the wheel up and down to control the volume, single click to play and pause the music or video, and double click to jump to the next track. In the page down mode, it can help you navigate a page or a document. You can spin the wheel up and down to scroll through the pages, single click to jump to the top of the document, and double click to go to the bottom. And that's pretty much all you can do with the wheel without the software installed. I think it's pretty cool, but it would be nicer if they can make this wheel more accessible. The wheel has a tactile bump to it, but it's being walled from scrolling up and down. Maybe removing this top piece would help, and while we're at it, maybe move it to the right hand side as well? Anyways, the keyboard itself is pretty heavy, so it is possible to click the knob single-handedly without moving the keyboard around the table, as long as you can find the right force. There are some other Fn features. We have the standard where you hit Fn plus Windows to lock the Windows key, and hold Fn plus Escape key for a few seconds to reset the keyboard. You also have the ability to set the refresh rate for this keyboard to tailor your needs. And now let's take a look at the back of the keyboard. We have 3 rubber pads on the bottom and 2 flip-out feet on the top, which are rubberized. The wire is not detachable, and it's just a plain rubber wire, but you have a Drevo branded wire organizer. And the USB is also styled with Drevo, so you know this is for your keyboard when you look at your dock. In the middle section here, there's this extra switch control. The info is on the left-hand side, but the one I'm particularly interested in is this layout feature. So, instead of QWERTY, if you type in Dvorak, COMAC, or MINIMAC, you can flip the switches here and you can basically type in Dvorak or whatever anywhere on any machine without relying on the software level. It's really nice of them to think of this, and I think more keyboard companies should support this feature as well. With that, let's do a quick type test to capture the typing sound. The switches that I have here is Get Around Red. I'm not sure what's missing, but it feels a bit hollow to me. I don't feel pain anywhere while typing on this keyboard for a long period of time though. I picked this one up from Amazon for $57 when it was on sale. The overall design looks nice. The functionalities of the wheel and the layout switch on the back of the keyboard makes me fairly happy. I would definitely recommend it if you see it on sale from a trusted seller.